Sue has always wanted a newer Camaro, but all the money she managed to save always ended up going back into her family. She's an incredibly giving person who never hesitates to sacrifice her own wants and needs for those of her family and friends.
When Sue's dad passed in 1986, she kept his muscle car passions alive, saving up enough money to buy a Camaro of her own.
It wasn't exactly the car of her dreams, but it was pretty close. And today, her world's gonna get turned upside down.
Valet.
I don't understand what you're talking about.
You don't have a valet parking?
No, we don't have a valet at second floor.
We just got our car stolen.
Are you serious?
Yeah, serious.
Seriously, when the valet was right here?
He moved those two to your car. Yeah.
I can call the police, because I've been hearing about car thefts here, but let me call them. Hi, I'm calling from second floor restaurant on the corner of Main and Walnut. I have two customers that said they valeted. Yeah, but we don't have a valet here. Okay, thank you so much. They said they have a unit around the corner and they're gonna send them right away.
And that police officer around the corner? Of course he's on our team.
What kind of car was it?
ZL1 Camaro.
I'm sure there are a thousand thoughts running through her head right now, and not one of them involves hidden cameras and Chip Foose.
Hi, officer.
Hi.
I have these two customers that said they valeted the car, but we don't have a valet.
Okay. Tell me what this valet looked like.
He had blonde hair. Yeah, kind of a thin build, blondish hair. Blondish like it had been bleached.
While Sue pleads her case, Chip gets into the car with our valet, ready for the next move.
Nice grab.
This actually sounds a little bit familiar to me. Let me make a quick phone call, see if I can get some more information for you, all right? Douglas, you there?
Officer Tony, what's happening?
You sound like you're in a car right now. You're around the area of Huntington?
Yes, I am.
What are you driving right now, by chance?
Camaro.
Camaro? What color Camaro?
Charcoal gray.
Charcoal gray? I'm gonna make a deal with you. I'm gonna need you to bring that car back to second floor right now, okay?
You're taking all my fun?
I got a nice lady down here who's missing her car and she's real upset.
And no problems if we bring it back now?
You bring it back right now and we'll see what we can do to work it out.
All right. Bye.
Got him.
Let's go.
There's a car thief that's kind of been around the area for 15 years or so. Who likes to do this? He'll take cars, he'll go joyriding, that kind of thing.
Spoil all my fun?
Spoiling your fun.
Sue, congratulations, you're on Overhaulin.
Oh my God. I was ready to kill him. Oh my God.
I was ready to kill somebody 5 minutes ago, you know, but I thought somebody stole my car, and then out pops Chip Foose. I'm like, wow, okay, this is awesome. Having that car stolen is like taking part of my identity away. I was overwhelmed.
So how are you guys feeling right now, or how are you feeling?
I'm excited. I'm a little overwhelmed. Couldn't believe it. We were sitting in there. I said, you know, that valet is going to take off in my car. He's going to go joyriding.
Now, how do you feel being on Overhaulin?
I'm thrilled. I don't even know what to say. I'm so excited. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I can't believe you. It's a little concerning how well he's able to keep a secret and a lie.
The original ZL1 Camaro power plant was conceived as a lightweight race engine. The 427 cubic inch beast was never actually intended for production vehicles. The iconic ride was born because of a forward-thinking dealer named Fred Gibb out of Illinois, who used Chevy's special order system to create a performance model not offered from the factory. They were light, fast, and rare, with only 69 ZL1 Camaros being produced in 1969. It wasn't until 2012 that Chevy revived the ZL1 name as a high-performance variant of the fifth-generation Camaros, technically making it the first regular production ZL1 ever.
As the Camaro continues to undress, we also have to make sure all the bells and whistles of this machine are in working order.
Well, the guy's got the front end apart, and as you can see, Sue and Sam have pretty much
destroyed the lower front fascia, which has also damaged the inside structural piece. So we've ordered a new one of these, but there's also some damage and broken parts here behind the lower grill. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna bend up some sheet metal pieces, and with some panel bond, we'll be able to glue this back together, make that like brand new, as well as this piece here, replace that, put the new carbon fiber in place, and it's gonna be like brand new. We need to fix the paint defects that are in the car now, fix the damage that's in the car. That's why it's going right away to the body shop. It's all about the alteration and the changes that we're making to the car, not about restoring it and then making alterations. We just get to jump in and start modifying it and making it cool.
At the same time, the boys at Bill Dunn are hard at work.
Apparently, Sue's father had a 69 Camaro that had this houndstooth material in it. So Chip's idea to bring this into the Camaro that we're doing now for her is so awesome.
You're peeking.
I'm not peeking.
No peeking.
I promise.
I'm gonna put you in your mark. Okay, right here.
Okay.
Okay, deep breath. Are you okay?
I'm good.
Okay.
I'm getting
all right,
excited.
Keep those eyes closed, okay. Nice and tight, Sue.
Okay.
I know that you are part of a Camaro family.
I am.
Your parents both had Camaros. Your mom had a 70 and your dad had a cool 69. Yeah. What was your dad's name?
Jim Summerell.
Do you kind of feel like Jim is present with us today?
Yeah, I do. I do.
I knew that you were really close to Jim, and he's looking down on you with a lot of pride for continuing the love of the car and the horsepower DNA that runs through your family.
Yep.
We're very happy to have done this car for you. It's almost time, almost
You're
time.
Killing me, Chris.
I know, but I gotta ask you a question.
Sure.
Are you ready for your day to get a whole lot better?
I am ready.
All right, Sue, go ahead and open your eyes.
Wow, that's my car. Oh my goodness, oh my gosh, she's gorgeous. Oh God, she's gorgeous.
Chip.
Oh my God, the interior is beautiful. She's gorgeous, thank you so much. Thank you so
much. You're very welcome.
Oh wow, I can't believe it. Wow. Oh wow. He took all the things that I love about the Camaro and the lines of this body style, and he just made them better. And it's like that's how it's supposed to be. And it's beautiful. It's so beautiful.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank
welcome
you so
to the Overhaulin family.
Thank you so much. Oh, my gosh.
You're very welcome.
Oh, wow.
Well, as you know, I sat down with Sam,
mm-hmm.
and we talked about what you loved about the car and what you might want to do to it.
Okay.
He said that this was your favorite color. And so we really didn't change the color, but we went ahead and fixed all the little scratches and problems that the car had.
Okay.
And as you can see, the carbon fiber hood scoop. And then knowing that your father's 69 had the rally stripes, I did a modern rally stripe. So we have the carbon scoop. We also brought some carbon into the back. It is a real carbon fiber deck lid.
Oh, wow.
And rear wing. The exhaust system that's coming out stainless all the way.
Nice. She's going to have a nice little roar.
And you did notice the brakes.
Yes.
So we painted your calipers, but we used the errata speed, the larger rotors.
Oh, nice.
And these are the very first set of Foos forged wheel.
Beautiful.
They just came in last night.
Wow.
And we got them on the car, so you have the very first set.
And next up, the beef.
Oh, wow.
So the magazine supercharger, we also polished your strut tower.
Nice.
Put a cool air intake system on it. We dynoed it, and we have increased the horsepower about 100 horsepower.
Oh, wow. Wow.
So
well,
I guess you can get to work pretty quick now.
Yeah.